A very good afternoon. You are watching Rajya Sabha Television. I am Smriti Rastogi with the midday news. Let's begin the bulletin with the top headlines. Mayawati pulls out of Mahagathbandhan in Uttar Pradesh, blames Samajwadi Party for the recent Lok Sabha election defeat. BSP to contest upcoming five polls in the state alone. Kerala confirms one case of Nipah virus in the state. Condition of the 23-year-old patient stable, says Health State Minister. Urges people to not panic. Center sends team of six senior doctors to monitor the situation. Bolstering infrastructure, creating jobs through small industries will be our priority, asserts Nitin Gadkari, takes charge as Minister for Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises. Pratap Chandra Sarangi takes charge as MOS, MSME. Harshvardhan gets Science and Technology Ministry. Mahendra Nath Pandey is the new Skill Development Minister. Massive search operation underway to locate missing IAF aircraft AN-32 with 13 people on board missing since yesterday after takeoff from Assam's Jorhat. Army deploys all resources to carry out search operations. Defence Minister seeks status report. Severe heat wave continues to sweep several parts of India. Rajasthan's Turu remains the hottest at 50.3 degrees Celsius. IMD says conditions to continue for the next few days. Health Ministry issues advisory to stay safe during heat wave conditions. The BSP has pulled out of its alliance with the Samajwadi Party after the recent drubbing in the Lok Sabha elections. Making the announcement earlier today, BSP chief Mayawati announced that her party will contest the by-polls in Uttar Pradesh alone, but did not rule out reuniting with the Samajwadi Party again in the future. Mayawati held Akhilesh Yadav-led Samajwadi Party responsible for the poor show of the Mahagathbandhan, saying that the Samajwadi Party cadre was not as committed as those of the BSP. 11 assembly by-polls are due in Uttar Pradesh after the respective MLAs won the Lok Sabha polls. The BJP won 62 of the 80 seats in the state, while the Gathbandhan bagged just 15, with the BSP winning 10 and Samajwadi Party 5 in the recently concluded Lok Sabha polls.
हमारे ये रिश्ते केवल अपने राजनीतिक स्वार्थ के लिए ही नहीं बने हैं, बल्कि ये रिश्ते आगे भी हर सुख दुख की घड़ी में हमेशा ऐसे ही बने रहेंगे। अर्थात हमारे ये रिश्ते अब कभी भी खत्म होने वाले नहीं हैं। ऐसी मेरी तरफ से ये हमेशा पूरी पूरी कोशिश बनी रहेगी। लेकिन वही दूसरी तरफ राजनीतिक व्यवस्थाओं को भी पूरी तरह से नज़रअंदाज नहीं किया जा सकता है, ये भी सभी जानते हैं। और इसलिए अभी अभी संपन्न हुए लोकसभा चुनाव के संबंध में जो परिणाम खासकर उत्तर प्रदेश में उभर कर सामने आए हैं, तो उस पर बड़े दुख के साथ ये कहना पड़ता है कि इस चुनाव में सपा का बेस वोट अर्थात यादव समाज अपने यादव बहुल्य, जहां पर इनकी पॉपुलेशन ज़्यादा है, अपने यादव बहुल्य सीटों पर भी सपा के साथ पूरी मजबूती के साथ टिका हुआ नहीं रह सका है।
बात रखी गई है, मैं उस पर बहुत सोच समझ कर विचार करूंगा, और जब गठबंधन के चुनाव में है ही नहीं उपचुनाव में, तो हम अपनी समाजवादी पार्टी की तैयारी करेंगे। समाजवादी पार्टी भी 11 सीटों पर पार्टी से राय मशवरा कर करके अकेले लड़ेगी, उसका विचार हम लोग कर लेंगे बहुत जल्दी।
And for more on this, we'll go across to our correspondent Panchanan Mishra, who is joining us on the phone line. Panchanan, what we are given to understand the latest development of this are that BSP has pulled out of its alliance with the Samajwadi Party and Mayawati has held Akhilesh Yadav-led Samajwadi Party responsible for the recent debacle and poor show in the Lok Sabha elections. What more inputs do you have on this?
Exactly, Smriti. Everything is not good looking in this alliance of BSP, SP and RLD. Because just the elections have concluded and the result was out on 23rd. And now Mayawati is realizing that she was not in profit due to this coalition. However, in last 2014 election, Mayawati was in zero. And now she has her party has gained 10 seats in Lok Sabha, which is a big bigger seat. But she is now saying that this coalition is not worked for her and the Yadav votes were not transferred in favor of this coalition. So now, unilaterally, she yesterday decided to pull out, not exactly pull out, but she hinted that she will go alone in for this 11 by-election assembly seats, which we are going to vacant due to the MLAs are chosen for MPs. So if the BJP, if the BSP is going alone, then now Samajwadi Party also declared that it will also go solo in this 11 assembly seats. So the coalition is looking in danger. And there is a selfishness also, and there is a political compulsion looking for this breaking away of this coalition. And now, as the BJP was saying, as the other opposition party was saying, that this is a, this coalition was looking, this coalition was made only for these political practices and not, it was not basically on a principle.
Right.
So it has to be go on that way. So now we have to see that officially they will announce breaking away or as Mayawati has said that in future she might consider reuniting with Akhilesh Yadav and she also appreciated him. So we have to see that what shape this coalition will take place.
Thank you so much, Panchanan, for joining us and giving us all those inputs on that latest development of the day. Moving on, bolstering country's infrastructure and creating jobs through small industries will be the priority for the senior BJP leader, Nitin Gadkari, who took charge as Minister for Road Transport, Highways and Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises Ministries today. Pratap Chandra Sarangi also took charge as MOS in the ministry.
हमारी स्वाभाविक रूप से प्राथमिकता है कि ग्रामीण और कृषि क्षेत्र में हम ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा रोजगार निर्माण करें और एग्रीकल्चर वेस्ट से लेकर और हमारी गांवों में जिस जिस प्रकार के रॉ मटेरियल अवेलेबल हैं उसके आधारित उद्योग वहीं के वहीं शुरू हो और उसमें बड़ा रोजगार गांवों में रूरल एग्रीकल्चर इकोनॉमी में निर्माण हो। अर्बन सेक्टर में भी अलग अलग फील्ड को हमने रिसर्च सेंटर्स खोले हैं, उसके साथ साथ अभी हम लोग और भविष्य के नए इंडिया की जो प्रधानमंत्री की सोच है उसके आधार पर कौन से नए क्षेत्र और है जिसमें जाके हम लोग हमारा काम कर सकते हैं, इसको करेंगे।
And Dr. Harshvardhan today took charge as a Union Science and Technology Minister. After taking over, he said that his Science and Technology Ministry will strive to make India the top 3 scientific nation of the world by 2030.
आज के इस अवसर पर मैं उन्हें प्रधानमंत्री जी को आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ, अपने राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष श्री अमित शाह जी को आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ, अपने सभी अधिकारियों को और अपने सभी देश के वैज्ञानिकों को आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ जिन्होंने पिछले 5 साल हमें खूब समर्थन किया, सहयोग किया, हम लोगों के सपने को अपना सपना बनाया और आने वाले 5 वर्षों के अंदर हम इस सारे काम की गति को कई गुना ज़्यादा तेज करेंगे और भारत का विज्ञान के माध्यम से भी नाम और ऊंचाइयों तक लेकर जाएंगे। इसी संकल्प के साथ मैं आज ये मिनिस्ट्री में दोबारा चार्ज ले रहा हूँ।
Unemployment is going to be the top agenda for the skill ministry, said Mahendranath Pandey, the newly appointed Minister of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship today after taking charge. He said that India has a large young population and we would want to ensure that they are properly skilled in the sectors that they are working in. Heavy Industries and Public Enterprises Minister Arvind Sawant also assumed office today post taking charge. Sawant said among the important issues before the government, employment generation will be given high priority as this subject is directly associated with his Heavy Industries and Public Enterprises Ministry. Meanwhile, Thawar Chand Gehlot also took charge as the Union Minister for Social Justice and Empowerment in New Delhi. The Rajya Sabha will meet from June 20th to July 26th for the upcoming session of the Parliament. In a press communique, the Rajya Sabha Secretariat announced on Monday that the President has summoned the Upper House to meet on June 20th, 2019 for the upcoming session of the Parliament. Subject of exigencies of business, the session is scheduled to conclude on Friday, which is July 26, 2019. The first session of the 17th Lok Sabha will commence on 17th of July. The newly elected members will be administered the oath on the first 2 days and new speaker will be elected on June 19th. President Ram Nath Kovind will address the joint sitting of both the houses of the parliament in the Central Hall at 11 a.m. on 20th of June. A special one-day session of the Goa Legislative Assembly is convened today to elect the new speaker. The ruling BJP-led coalition alliance has fielded Rajesh Patnekar, who is pitted against Congress leader and former Chief Minister Pratap Singh Rane. The BJP-led ruling coalition has a strength of 24 in 40-member state legislative assembly, which includes 17 BJP MLAs, 3 MLAs of the Goa Forward Party, 1 MLA from the MGP and 3 independents. The opposition currently comprises 15 Congress MLAs and 1 legislator of the Nationalist Congress Party. The post of Goa Assembly Speaker is lying vacant since Pramod Sawant left the post to take charge as the state chief minister after the demise of Manohar Parrikar in March. An election of Speaker and Deputy Speaker will also take place in Arunachal Pradesh today. BJP, led by Chief Minister Pema Khandu, secured a landslide victory by winning 41 seats in the 60-member assembly in the elections held simultaneously with the Lok Sabha elections. And Kerala government has confirmed one case of Nipah virus in the state. State Health Minister K.K. Shailja confirmed that a 23-year-old college student infected with a Nipah virus is undergoing treatment at a private hospital in Kochi and his condition remains stable. As a precautionary measure, 86 people who interacted with a patient in the last 10 days are also under medical observation. Shailja has urged people not to panic and take all precautionary measures to prevent the spread of the disease. Meanwhile, Health Minister Harshvardhan has also assured help to the state to contain the spread of the virus. The government has also sent a team of 6 senior government health officials to Kerala to monitor the situation. Nipah virus is transmitted from animals to humans and then spreads through the people-to-people contact. 18 Nipah cases were reported in Kerala last year, out of which 17 patients had died.
Yesterday, when I took charge of health ministry, I am seized of the total issue. Yesterday itself, we had dispatched a team of 6 officers to senior officers, epidemiologists, scientists to Kerala. They have already arrived there yesterday. I had spoken to the health minister of Kerala yesterday also, in the morning also. We have lined up everything. We are flying monoclonal antibodies also to Kerala. We have set up a control room in NCDC in New Delhi also. स्टेट गवर्नमेंट हैज ऑल्सो मेड ऑल अरेंजमेंट्स फॉर सर्वेलेंस कॉन्टैक्ट ट्रेसिंग्स एक्सेट्रा. टिल नाउ अबाउट 86 कॉन्टैक्ट्स हैव बीन ट्रेस्ड. वी आर फॉलोइंग द इलनेस ऑफ one case which has reported positive after confirmation from NIV Pune late midnight yesterday, and for all these contacts, whosoever develops any fever, as is the protocol, we will subject him also to testing.
And massive search operations continue to locate missing AN-32 transport aircraft on the Indian Air Force. IAF and Indian Army has deployed all its resources to locate the aircraft. Indian Air Force has deployed Sukhoi 30 compact aircraft and C-130 special operations aircraft on a search mission for locating the missing aircraft. On Monday, AN-32 aircraft with 13 people on board lost contact with ground agencies around 33 minutes after it took off from Jorhat in Assam. According to the IAF, the aircraft got airborne at around 12:25 p.m. and lost all contacts with the ground staff at around 1 p.m. Those on the aircraft comprised 5 crew and 8 passengers. Meanwhile, Defence Minister Rajnath Singh has said that he had spoken to the Vice Chief of the Air Force on steps to find the missing aircraft and was praying for the safety of all those on board. And with that, we'll slip into a very quick break. More news and updates on the other side. Stay with us.
Tales that inspire. Stories of social change. A salute to diversity. Promoting public discourse. Events that motivate. Inspiring the innovative spirit. Watch Rajya Sabha television documentaries.
Welcome back. Seen as a landmark move for the country's animal husbandry sector, the formation of a separate ministerial portfolio for animal husbandry, dairying and fisheries under the newly formed Narendra Modi government has been welcomed by the dairy institutions and bodies. The Indian Veterinary Association and Pashu Chikitsak Mahasangh have welcomed the government's decision. The IVA has also thanked the government for introduction of combined vaccine of FMD, that is foot and mouth disease, and HS on trial basis.
A revolutionary step was taken by the government of India, and during the first phase, during the trial period, Haryana has been allotted and we have vaccinated 70 lakh animals against FMD in first phase, and 70 lakhs we will be vaccinating in the second stage. Consensus, all the states of Union of India, they have been empowered to go for dual vaccination, combined vaccination. This is a major achievement.
And Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu today offered prayers at Lord Balaji Temple in Andhra Pradesh's Tirumala. Priests recorded a traditional welcome to the Vice President and his family members on their arrival at the main entrance of the holy shrine. After being led into the sanctorum, Naidu will attend the special cultural and literary programs. And weather update now. Heat wave continued to sweep several parts of India, with Churu in Rajasthan remaining the hottest in the country at 50.3 degrees Celsius. Temperatures remained 3 to 5 notches above normal in Haryana, Rajasthan and Jammu and Kashmir. While there was slight relief for Odisha and Telangana after the states received scattered rains. The maximum temperature in Delhi was 40.6 degrees Celsius on Monday. The Indian Meteorological Department has said that the national capital is likely to get some respite from the scorching heat today. Met officials have predicted a partly cloudy sky with chances of rain or thunderstorm accompanied by lightning and gusty winds. The Met Department has predicted severe heat wave in East and West Rajasthan for the next 2 days. According to the Met Department forecast, many places in the two states could get respite over the next few days. Jammu and Kashmir's winter capital, Jammu, also recorded an above normal maximum temperature at 41.1 degrees Celsius. Vidarbha and Marathwada regions in Maharashtra also battled heat wave conditions. Meanwhile, rains brought relief to residents in some parts of the country. Various parts of Hyderabad and its neighbouring areas in Telangana received a brief spell of rain on Monday. Rains in most parts of Odisha, mainly the western region, brought down the mercury. According to the IMD forecast, no significant changes in maximum temperatures are likely over the next 2 to 3 days. Meanwhile, Health Ministry has also issued a health advisory for people to stay safe during the heat wave conditions prevailing in the country. The ministry has suggested people to stay indoors and in shaded places, use umbrella when outside and wear thin loose cotton and light coloured garments. People were advised to stay hydrated. They have also been advised against going out in the sun. And now let's take a look at the weather update. International developments now. 9 Muslim ministers and 2 provincial governors have resigned on Monday to allow the Sri Lankan government to allow the investigation into the allegations against some of them on links to an Islamist extremist group blamed for the deadly Easter suicide bombings. Their resignations came 4 days after thousands of people demanding the expulsion of 3 Muslim leaders whom they alleged were linked to the National Tawheed Jamaat, the banned outfit blamed for the attacks on 3 Colombo hotels and 3 churches on April 21st. And at least 30 protesters, including an 8-year-old child, were killed after security forces opened fire at the main protest camp in Sudan capital on Monday. Security forces shot pro-democracy demonstrators outside the country's military headquarters to break up a weeks-long sit-in. The assault on Monday was the worst violence in Sudan since the 11th of April overthrow of the long-time leader Omar al-Bashir. Rallies against Bashir's 3-decade rule led to his ouster in April, but protesters had remained outside the army headquarters calling on the generals to cede powers on a transitional authority. The United Nations has condemned the use of excessive force by the security forces against protesters and called for an independent investigation. Meanwhile, following Monday's deadly violence, Sudan's Transitional Military Council announced cancellation of all previous agreements with the main opposition coalition and called for snap elections. And news now from the ICC Cricket World Cup 2019. Pakistan defeated England by 14 runs at Trent Bridge last night as the World Cup's first centuries from Joey Root and Josh Butler were not enough to help the host overhaul a daunting target of 349. England put Pakistan to bat first after winning the toss. The visitors put a solid 348 runs for 8 wickets in their 50 overs. Mohammad Hafiz was the top scorer with 84 off 62 balls, while Babar Azam made 63 and captain Sarfaraz Ahmed put 55 runs on board. Pakistan then restricted England at 334 for 9 wickets in 50 overs. For the host, Joey Root was the highest scorer with 107 runs off 104 balls, while Josh Butler made 103 runs off 76 balls. In today's match, Afghanistan will take on Sri Lanka at Cardiff at 3 p.m. Indian time. And that's all we have for you in this edition. Thank you for watching. Namaskar.